everyone. Today we're going to go over 5 analysis charts and visualizations that researchers find helpful. These charts really speak across several different methodologies, so they're useful on many different fronts. So I'm in my Dedoose project here. I'm on the home screen, and I'm going to pop over to the Analyze workspace. And just for some context, this study was documenting college athlete experiences with surveillance, discipline, and punishment within their athletic department, and how those experiences were racialized and gendered. So the first chart that Dedoose will always land you on is the code times descriptor chart. So this chart is really great for visualizing any patterns or relationships across all of your codes by a descriptor of your choice. So you'll see from this drop-down menu, you can choose which descriptor you want to visualize or investigate. Right now it's set to gender. And then all of your codes will be listed here on the left. So abuse, choice process, athletic department policies, and so on. All of these were my codes in the project. And then you'll see that code is going to be disaggregated by the descriptor of your choice. So here, this is telling me, hey, women talked a lot more about abuse or hostile conditions than men. And what's great about these charts is that whether you're on a bar graph or a chart where there's numbers, they're all live and dynamic. So you can click into this bar and pull up the qualitative data that's making up that number. So here I can scan through all 52 excerpts that are making up this chart. So again, this was women talking about hostile conditions or abuse. I could export these. I could make a data set out of it, a subset of my data within this project. And under matching resources, you can see what participants or what media were represented in this chart. So here, this was 9 participants, 9 women, and again, 52 excerpts. So just a quick note here, on the upper right, you have some options. So as a standard, normalize is checked for you. And what this is doing is trying to quote unquote make everything equal so that you could do an apples to apples comparison here. So it's magnifying how many men I had in this project so that I could do a direct comparison, but you can always toggle that off to get the accurate representation of these numbers. And I would suggest doing that, especially when you are ready to pull these charts or report any numbers. You also have the option to see the code counts instead of the percentage. So I'm going to click that off. So now I can see, okay, women talked about abuse or hostile conditions 52 times compared to 5 times for men. If you have any subcodes under this root code here, you can choose to include those. And you also have the option for hit/miss. And this would be a representation of how many descriptors had that code applied. So if I turn this on, it's now going to show me, okay, 9 women talked about abuse or hostile conditions, 2 men talked about abuse or hostile conditions. So that's great for when you want to see how many people or how many pieces of media you had under that specific code. Alrighty, now I'm going to move on to the inverse of this chart, which is the descriptor times code chart. This is where you can isolate a specific code you're interested in and visualize how that code was represented across all of your descriptor categories. So here it's set on surveillance. I'm going to choose activism as a code. And now I'm seeing that code disaggregated by all of my descriptors. Next, we have the code co-occurrence chart. This is one of my favorites. So this is basically a huge heat map visualizing how many times 2 codes were applied to the same excerpt or were overlapping. on the same excerpt. So this is really great for visualizing larger themes in your data. For instance, you know, my attention is immediately drawn to this 81. So what this is telling me is 81 times the code coach interaction or relationship was occurring with power dynamic or coercive power dynamic. So this is telling me when folks were talking about their interactions with their coaches or their relationship with their coaches, they were also simultaneously talking about a coercive power dynamic. And again, you can always click in to these charts and pull up the qualitative data behind it if you want to pull out a quote or do further subcoding on this, you can. So again, matching resources, 16 participants out of 20 had a very high co-occurrence with coach interaction and a coercive power dynamic. So this chart is color-coded. You may notice that the higher the number, the warmer the color, the lower the number, the cooler the color. So it's really trying to draw your attention to those higher numbers, but just remember that absence is as significant and telling as presence. So also pay attention to those lower numbers or where there is not any co-occurrence at all and make note of that. So if there was something you expected or anticipated would come up here, that's not, make sure to make note of that as well. All right, and just below that, we have code application, which is just a breakdown of how many times a code was applied to an individual piece of media. So I have all of my media here, which were my interviews, and then all of my codes across the top. So for instance, this is telling me Whitney talked about academics 5 times. And so on. You'll always have the total code application running on the bottom here and also on the side. Same thing with that previous chart. And with any of these charts, you can export them. So just know that if you want to export this and put it in a paper or a presentation, you can do so. Next, I'm going to go to the descriptor field times code grid chart. This chart is really awesome because you can build your own chart and visualize what you want. Really great for intersectional analyses as well. So you'll see here you have the option to choose what descriptors you want represented in this chart. I'm going to add gender, so select gender from the drop-down menu and then select add field. So gender will be in our chart, and now we can choose which codes we want to visualize here. So let's just select some injury codes and then just some random ones as well. And you'll see that this chart starts populating as soon as you select those codes. So this is giving me a breakdown of how many times that code was applied. So men talked about injury and pain 23 times. Women talked about injury and pain 65 times. And again, you can always click into the chart and pull up the raw data behind those numbers. But let's say you wanted to do a more intersectional analysis of this. You can add as many descriptors as you want to this chart. So I'm going to add race by clicking add field, and now you'll see that this has been disaggregated by race and gender. So for instance, with men here, men talked about injury and pain 23 times. Of those 23, 3 of them were Black, 9 Latino, 10 white, and 1 identified as multiracial. So again, really great for intersectional analysis. And you can add as many as you want. So if we add career status, it will break it down by race, gender, and career status. So you can get very, very specific here. Alrighty, and then to close this out, I just want to make note of 2 other charts that folks really love, and that is the packed code cloud. This is really great for presentations or to put in a paper to give an overview of what concepts or themes were central to your study. So you have different color options here. If you want this to be mostly horizontal, you can. And you can also include subcode counts. So the larger the font, the more prominent that code was in your study. And again, if you hover over it, it's going to give you the number, and you can always get back to the qualitative data behind it. And lastly, we have our descriptor ratios chart. Wanted to just point your attention to this. If you wanted to have an overview or snapshot of all of your descriptor categories, if you wanted to quickly visualize participant information such as demographics, or perhaps you had survey results, they would be represented here as well. And you can switch to a bar chart if you're not a fan of the pie graph. And these can be reordered as well. So if they're not in an order that you like, you can switch those around by going to your descriptor workspace. So there are dozens and dozens of chart options here on the left-hand side, but those are 5 to 7 charts that will get you up and going and really show you the power of Dedoose's visualization tools.